you may have a seat. Woo! All right, that is the way to start off the morning. Boys and girls, I believe this is the first morning. This is morning what? Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, morning three, right? First morning assembly that we've had where the sun is already out. I saw the forecast today said it's going to be about 81 in Santa Cruz, so I don't know what that means for Aptos, but let's keep praying that the weather is just right for Water Day this afternoon. So far, it's feeling pretty good. In fact, you might even morning, and at some point in time, those sprinklers might even come on to kind of cool you off. I mean, I don't know, it might be a little bit early to do it right now, but you never know when those sprinklers go up, what might just go off. Boys and girls, thanks so much for being here today. We're so excited as an assembly team to continue to teach you, and also for us as the assembly team to learn ourselves a bit more about who God is and what he thinks about us and the plans that he has for us. So I want you to understand that, boys and girls. Those of you who are on teams, first grade, second grade. Who are my first graders? Raise your hand. All right, first graders. How about my second graders? Just keep those applauses going. Third graders. Fourth. Fifth. Sixth. How about my junior VBSers? Where are my junior VBSers? How about kinder? All right, we got all kinds of kids out here. That those of us who are a little bit older, you know, just a little bit older than you, we are, we're learning things this week too. We're learning things about God. We're being reminded about, we're being reminded, God is reminding us of things that we, you know, may have already learned, but sometimes we forget. And sometimes there's new things that God wants to teach us. And you know, the Bible is really an amazing thing. The Bible is just this, it's not just a book. It's a collection of the things, the thoughts that God has for us. The instructions that he has for us and the ways that he wants to teach us to live. And do you know that the Bible says in one of the books of the Bible, and it says that the Word of God or God's Word, the Bible, it's alive. Now that doesn't mean that when you're sitting down at the table and you see your Bible there, it doesn't just start getting up and start dancing and moving around or something like that. But what it means is that the words that are there, they're powerful. We don't just read the Bible once like you might read a book that you like and then you're done with it and you move on to the next book. The Bible we can keep coming back to over and over and over and over again and learn new things and have new understandings. And that's one of the things I love so much about the Bible and about knowing God is that he always has more things that he wants to teach us from his word. And so this morning, as we begin our assemblies, we're going to be learning about forgiveness today. We're going to be learning about forgiveness. And this is a very, very important, not just a concept, but a very important understanding and a very important practice, and a very important thing that we also have to learn how to receive. And so this morning, let's welcome out onto the stage to teach us a little bit about this morning's verse from Colossians. Hashtag true story.
Guys doing? Where's Charlie at tonight?
We don't like her anymore.
No, she always has the best snacks and she never shares her snacks with us. She always has the best ones.
Not sharing, huh? Feeling a little bit kind of left out and kind of forgotten, huh?
Uh-huh.
Oh, okay. Well, do you think you could forgive her?
Already? I mean, again? We already forgave her.
Forgave her, huh? How many times?
We forgave her 3 times.
3 times? Yeah. Well, you know, Peter had the same kind of question with Jesus, and he was asking him how many times he should forgive him.
He did?
Oh, yeah.
What did Jesus say? Because we already forgave her 3 whole times.
Well, how would you guys feel if you only got forgiven 3 times by God? Oh. Yeah. So, Peter asked Jesus, and Peter thought 7 would be a lot. But you know what Jesus said? Not 7, but 7 times 70.
7 times 70, that's huge.
That's like a billion.
Is that like infinity?
Is it like a Googleplex?
Yeah.
Googleplex, what's a Googleplex?
A Googleplex is like the biggest number ever.
Dad, how many is a Googleplex?
Yeah, it's pretty big, but I think the idea is that we gotta forgive a lot, just like Jesus forgave us. So, guess what? I have a Bible story.
Can we hear it? Can we hear
it?
Yeah. Bible story.
All right.
Whoops.
So Jesus said that once upon a time, there was a king, and he wanted to settle all his debts. And that was...
Well, young lady, come hence. Young lady, yes, you owe me $1 million, and that's a lot of money.
That's way more money than I have.
But you know the rules, you've got to pay.
But the dog ate my homework, and the landlord raised the rent, and the baby needs new shoes, and I can't pay you. Oh, I can't. Please forgive me.
Stop groveling. So, you know, if you can't pay, I'm going to have to turn you over here to Just Ice. He's going to tickle you till you cry.
No.
He's going to tickle your family.
Oh, no,
he's
going to
tickle your dog.
Not my dog.
5 times a day until you pay back all.
Oh, but I can't. No, please. I can't. Please forgive me. Please forgive me. Please forgive me. Please. Please.
Enough. Please? Please stop groveling.
Oh, here, all right.
Step up here, young lady. Okay. Well.
Please.
I am the king.
Well, the puppy dog
which
eyes.
Means I have to be sure the people follow all the rules.
The rules.
The rules, right, Ice Baby?
That's right.
However, because I am the king, I also have the power to eliminate all debts. I'm having a nice day, aren't I, Ice?
Hey, you're doing pretty good.
All right, okay. Really? So, I have decided to absolve you of all debt, to forgive you, and let you go on your way.
I'm forgiven! Oh, King, I love you, I love you!
All right, that's enough.
Sorry.
Oh.
Sorry. Phew. Oh.
Hi, how are you?
I'm doing well. How
excellent,
are you?
Excellent.
Good to
Good night,
see
thanks.
You.
Yeah. It's okay,
it's
just
a
wonderful.
Great day.
Wonderful. Yeah, nice blue out
day.
Here. Water day, I guess. Forgiving. Yeah. Nice.
Yes. So, I was talking with the king.
Uh-huh.
And he's been trying to collect his debts.
Uh-huh.
And that kind of reminded me, don't you owe me $100?
Yeah, I do. I do. I do owe you $100.
You're gonna pay me back, right?
Yeah, at some point. At some point. I don't have it now.
But I need I need the money now.
I can pay you $20 on payday. Like, you know.
That is not gonna
weeks.
Work.
2 weeks, $20.
No, I can't pay you back.
I don't have it. The dog ate my homework. And the baby needs new shoes and the landlord raised the rent!
Where have I heard that? No, those excuses don't cut it. Hey, Just Ice!
Oh, no!
You want to tickle somebody? Go tickle her until she pays me back.
No!
Well, really? Hello again. Didn't we speak earlier, young lady?
Oh, yes, Your Highness, you're higher than Highness, and you forgave me, and that was so wonderful.
I forgave you $1 million, I believe.
I believe you're right.
It's my biggest write-off this week.
That was such a relief. Thank you so
much. Yes, so how's the rest of your day been going?
Oh, you know, sun's out.
I believe I saw you talking to your friend. What was that all about?
Oh, you know, just friends.
She owed you $100, didn't she? I heard that.
How did you know that?
Well, I was listening very carefully. I was over here. You didn't see me.
Huh?
Yeah, well.
You were there?
Now,
you saw?
I forgave you.
You saw?
Of $1 million.
I'm in trouble now.
And you couldn't forgive her of $100?
Well, you know she was never going to pay me back.
Well, you were never going to pay me back, but
well,
you were forgiven.
Different. Wow.
Ice, where did Ice go? Ice! Ice baby, come here. Here. All right, listen, Ice.
Did I see that?
Things have changed. We've changed our plans a little bit.
What's happening?
Well, what's happening is she could not forgive someone after she was forgiven.
Tough nuggets.
Yeah, okay. So I think that you know what that means.
Dave,
the law is the law.
The law is the law. We're going to forget about the pardon. Go to tickling.
Wow! Well, that girl was in big trouble.
Yeah, Dad, what happened in that story?
Well, think about it. She was forgiven so much, over $1 million. But yet she wouldn't forgive somebody for just 100?
Oh. So God forgives us all the time?
You mean like when I put peanut butter in my little brother's hair?
Yep.
Or like when I fed my broccoli to the dog?
Oh, broccoli.
Yep. So what about Charlie? Do you think she should be forgiven?
Oh.
Oh my goodness, we should forgive her.
Yeah.
I wish she was here so we could say we were sorry.
We're sorry.
Oh.
What are you doing?
Is there someone at the door?
I think she's at the door.
Hi, girls.
Charlie! We're so sorry. We're so glad you're here.
We're so glad you're here. We wanted to ask you for your forgiveness.
Will you forgive us?
Well, I came here to ask you for forgiveness because I realized I wasn't really sharing very good with you guys. And so I brought my favorite cookies, speculaas. Oh, they're so good.
Would you forgive me?
Yeah. Oh, yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes.
Here, have some cookies.
Thank you.
Yeah, they're good.
I really wanted to jump through the book, but I decided against it. I don't want to take away the fun from the other team. Oh, this is such a powerful story. We're going to see another story about forgiveness this morning. But this story is really powerful because, you know, when I think about what happened in this story, this king who had the power to forgive the debt of this particular, in this case, this woman, she owed him $1 million. I mean, does anybody have $1 million lying around to pay off a debt? I don't. I mean, really? Can I get a loan from you after the assemblies? But seriously, boys and girls, seriously, $1 million, that's a huge amount of debt. And can I have your attention, please? $1 million is a lot of money, and it's not really so much the amount. The point of the story is that could this lady actually pay off her debt, what she owed this king? Could she really do it? No. Could she do it? No. She couldn't do it. And the king decided to be merciful, and because he had the power to forgive her of that debt, to say, you know what, you don't owe it to me anymore, he went ahead and did it. Now, later on we saw in the story, I mean, it was a great illustration of a story from the Bible. That same lady, later on, went to somebody who owed her how much? How much?
$100.
All right, now we got some math minds out here. What times 100 equals a million? I think about 10,000, right? Okay, about 10,000, something like that. So the king, or excuse me, this lady who was only owed $100 by her friend, she thought, you know what? I want my money back. And the very same day that she had been forgiven all this money, this $1 million that she owed, she went back to this other woman and said, I need you to give me my $100 right now. And that made it really hard for this other lady. And she threatened her that she would be tickled and her family would be tickled every day, all day. Boy, wow. Do you think that's the way that God wants us to treat other people? She was taught, this woman was taught a really important lesson about forgiveness, and then she turned around and did the very opposite. You know, God tells us, we learn about in the Bible about treating people the way that we want to be treated. And I want you to think about that this morning. As you have team time, as you're with your team, as you're doing special events and games and projects and all that, how are you treating each other? I don't want you to answer me right now. I want you to think about it. How are you treating the people on your team? Are you treating them the way that you want to be treated? I want to encourage you to be thinking about the way that you want to be treated and treat others the same way. And know that the wonderful thing about God's forgiveness is that it teaches us that we don't have to be perfect in order to be forgiven. We don't have to be perfect in order to earn God's love. In fact, we don't have to earn it. He gives it to us freely. But there are things that we do sometimes that just really aren't okay. And we want to make sure that we, when we realize those things, we want to ask God for forgiveness so that we can really have the power and the freedom to go out and do differently. Well, we're going to see some more about forgiveness just now, because the Knights of the King are about to return to the VBS stage. So let's welcome them on out.
The next part of your quest is to go to the Spring of Forgiveness. There is much work that needs to be done there. Here are your tools.
Everything packaged in a good day's weight. Especially when it's the King's work.
Hold on there, take it easy. What was that you said about the King's work?
I thought it was really cool.
I know you're not afraid of hard work.
Yeah.
When it's the King's work.
No, not really.
Exactly. Well, stick together. You'll need the help of your friends. I must off, for I have ping pong practice today.
Oh, no need for the map, friends. I know the way. First we go for several miles past the Lake of Ludicrosity, over the hills of Hapless Hobbits, and then we end up at Spring of Forgiveness.
This shows a different way. It's a winding road that straightens out and goes through a grove of trees.
Ah, Veritasha, that is a long way. Don't you think Da Vinci would want us to maximize our time? Especially if there's lots of work to do, which may take all day.
Well, I think we should stick to the map. Da Vinci gave this to us as a guide. Besides, those trees are beautiful. It'd be a pity to bypass those.
Oh, Veritasha. We can see trees anytime back home, okay? Don't you know that the Spring of Forgiveness was my old stomping ground as a nightling? No one knows the land better than I do.
If I'm not mistaken, it sounds like you're disputing my judgment.
Okay, guys, let's not forget to be kind to one another.
Yeah, jeez. Let's just have a little refreshment, dude, before we just go any further, man.
There's no time to think about food. I'm ready to go now.
I am Dude. Who is with me?
Awkward.
I'm going to go this way. Have some time by myself and peace and quiet.
Wait, but didn't Da Vinci say to stick together?
Yes, but sometimes that needs a little solitude.
Okay. But, I don't know, what are we going to do?
Yeah.
Oh! We go to Da Vinci. Call me.
Go after them? I don't know. But I don't want to get split up either. This is a pickle.
That's why I said we just go to the Da Vinci. Tell him
okay.
The idea.
That's a good idea.
But he's at ping pong practice.
Well, no worries. He can always help us.
I can't believe Innocentia treated me that way. After all these long years of being friends, you'd think he'd understand me.
Perhaps you weren't that good of friends after all.
Who are you? You look awfully familiar.
Oh, my name is, Bob. Just think of me as an old friend. Now, back to the subject at hand. You were saying?
I was just thinking, why should Innocentia think that he knows what's best? It's obvious he's just being stubborn.
Yeah, and who is he to contradict you?
Usually like that? He can see things from my perspective. He really let me down.
Well, you know what? Knight. You should show him how much he hurt you. You should keep your distance.
I can't believe how Veritas treated me today. She's like, My friend, my amigo.
What troubles you, oh solitary traveler?
Many things. Who are you?
Just think of me as a new friend.
Okay.
Oh, but I do know everything that's been going on between you and Veritasha. Stick to the map indeed. Who needs that silly map?
And those trees.
Right? I know. You know what? It sounds like she's only thinking about herself.
See.
Yeah, you don't need a friend like that. It's better to be alone than to have a friend like that. But don't worry. I'll be here for you. Especially if you need a good shoulder to cry on.
Wait a second. That's my line. I can't help but think there's something awfully fishy going on. More than a simple disagreement. Chupacabra! Run! Hey! Wait.
What's this?
I don't know.
Wait, wait, wait. Why are we running? Quiet, you. Retreat in the name of the king. You don't have to be afraid of us. We're just here to help. We have some extra fruit rolls. There's a strawberry and grape and blueberry. There's blackberry too.
Okay.
Blackberry fruit rolls get him every time. That wasn't part of the plan at all.
Ignacentia.
Veritasha. Oh, thank you very much, my friend. How can I ever repay you?
No need. It's the Lord that brings us victory.
Oh, I'm so sorry for happening earlier today. I shouldn't have treated you that way. You're right to stick to the map since there were no bears around that route.
And I don't know what came over me either. You do know a way around the forest, and I should have just listened to your idea. Perhaps Grootificus was right when I was hungry. Well, that's no excuse. I never want to hurt your feelings.
Me neither, though I did. Will you forgive me?
Of course I can, and I hope that you'll forgive me. I never will lose a friend such as yourself.
I forgive you, Veritasha.
No! Okay. No! Yeah. No! Okay. No! My plan has been thwarted. They were supposed to stay mad at each other. That bear is useless.
Why'd I do that?
Bought off by a fruit roll? Indeed.
No.
Mmm. Fruit rolls. Oh, man! Now I want a fruit roll!
What happened though? Anyways, now that that's over, you want to go look at those trees you were talking about?
I would love to. Then perhaps we could take the Trail of Trotting Turtles that cuts back over to your shorter route.
Perfect idea, Veritasha.
Let's go.
All right. Okay. You never know when a bearer is going to appear on the VBS stage. Hey, can I just tell you? If you encounter a bear in the woods, don't go up to him and try to feed him fruit roll-ups, all right? I don't know if that would be the safest thing to do. I would suggest maybe walking back very cautiously. Maybe throw him a fruit roll or something, but don't go up to him and feed it to him. Hey, what was so cool about that story was that we saw two friends, right, get into a kind of an argument, get mad at each other, and what'd they do afterwards? They forgave each other, but they also did what? It starts with the letter A. They apologize to each other. False knight. I heard some of you identifying the false knight. I'm really glad that you identified the false knight. You don't have to say it out loud, but it's really good that you identified it because you're seeing that he is being very tricky. And he told Veritasha, he told both of them that, you should just be mad at her. You should just be mad at him. And you know what? Sometimes there are thoughts in our heads just like that. When we get upset at a brother or a sister or a friend, we kind of want to stay mad sometimes. And you know what? There is, just like there's a God out there, the one true God, who we can't see, but he's there. There's also other forces out there that try to lie to us and tell us to do things that we don't want to, that really aren't good, try to get us away from God's plans. And that will try to even keep us divided and separated from people that we really are supposed to love and who love us. So I love that you're identifying the false knight and his tactics, his strategies to try to bring what we call division or separation between people who God really meant to be together. So really well done. Keep watching closely about what the false knight does. But right now it's time for some science. Are you ready for some science? Doc Shanny Science Lab!
Shanny Science Lab.
Shanny!
Science is hashtag cool! Fresh! Look! Oxygen!
Shanny Science Lab.
Good morning! Good morning, everybody! How are you guys doing? Yeah. Learning about today, growing strong in forgiveness. So we're gonna do a little experiment this morning. So we've got four pitchers of water up here. And we're doing a little chemical reaction today, and I labeled these because we're learning about what?
Forgiveness.
Okay, so there are chemicals. We got water, in all of these. And we've got bleach here and something called iodine. And so you guys know what bleach does, right? We kind of use it to clean things, and it's really strong, kind of smells.
Keeps you white.
So I'm going to put some bleach in the Jesus pitcher. And I'm going to put some iodine in the sin pitcher. Ugh, it's like brown and gross and really nasty.
Ew.
All right. So gross, right? Okay, so we're doing chemical reactions here. Woo, there we go. Plenty of sin. We don't want any more. Let's be done with the sin.
No more.
Iodine. Yeah. Okay, so what happens when we're mixing these together? There's chemical reactions and it's breaking apart, and there's like different pieces. So there's like, have you guys ever done the sticks with the round foam things? And you're making like atoms, and you're learning about electrons and protons? Yes.
And neutrons.
And neutrons.
I like croutons.
Croutons. Okay, so when we're gonna mix these together, there's gonna be some chemical reactions. So, you know, we all sin, right? No one's perfect. We all sin. As soon as we're born, there's sin in our life. We were clean, and now we're all dirty, gross sin. Ah. And so the water and the iodine is gross. And sometimes we can try to do a lot of good things and try to get back to water, but
it doesn't seem like it's working.
It's not really working.
It's still dark.
Still dirty.
Still really dirty.
Pretty dirty.
And so Jesus came, and his forgiveness, there's not really a chemical reaction when Jesus comes, but this is a chemical reaction. So there's gonna be a chemical reaction, and if I put this bleach in here, do you think that's really dirty. There's not a lot of bleach.
Can't
do you
even
think
this see is gonna through clean it?
I can't even see through it. Kind of like the goggles I'm wearing.
All right, watch this. It's going to become clean. Isn't that amazing?
What?
So that's...
No way!
Chemical reaction right there. When Jesus comes in, he wipes all our sin away. And really, when he gave his life for us, he wiped all sin away, all sin that we'll ever do. So let's just see. Do you think, even with all the iodine that I put in there, do you think
it's the whole bottle?
It'll change it?
Everything.
All right, let's see. What?
No, it's completely gone.
All the bubbles.
Woo! Oh my gosh.
It's not
there
science without a medicine.
Oh, science! Yeah. Science! There we go!
Whoa, okay, Shani, let me get this straight. Thanks. What you're saying to me is that the water was us, and sin, it was the brown stuff, right? When you put the brown stuff into us, we get dirty, right?
Yes.
But Jesus is like this bleach water, right?
Yes.
And so when we have Jesus inside of us, it makes us clean?
Exactly.
Oh, I think I get it.
Yeah. God's forgiveness makes us clean again.
Yeah.
We are something different, just like this iodine is now different and gone.
That's wonderful. I like getting clean.
Okay, like, so remember, bleach. Be careful with these things. They will stain your hands and your clothes. So when you play with this later, be very careful.
When in doubt, wear 8 safety glasses.
At least.
All right. We'll see you guys later.
Doc Shani Science Lab.
Shani!
Thank you, Doc Shani. Science is hashtag cool.
Wow. You know, when they practice these Doc Shani Science Lab experiments, they don't actually do the experiment, so I don't get to see all of them. I know, you feel so sad for me, right? Oh. But, hey, I heard what was going on, and was that so cool? Like, the water was, like, stained, dirty, and then all of a sudden it was clean, right? Is that basically what happened? You don't have to explain the science to me. It's okay. And what a great illustration of God's forgiveness when it comes into our lives. You know, I heard Doc Shani say something that I thought was just, it was so simple, and it's so important for us to understand that everybody sins. You know, the Bible says that all sin, all fall short of God's glory. And when we talk about God's glory, we're talking about just everything awesome that is true about him. And God doesn't sin. He doesn't do wrong. He doesn't make mistakes. He didn't make a mistake when he was making you, by the way. He created you very purposefully the way that you are. But the Bible says that all sin, all of us sin, and fall short of God's glory. Have you ever watched, like in the Olympics, the long jump, when those people run really fast and they jump really far into a sand pit? Or the high jump, there's like a bar that's like up, like as high as this thing, and you're thinking, how is somebody going to jump over that? And they run and they jump, and they arch their back, and then they go over it. Have you ever seen that? So cool, right? Well, have you ever seen somebody hit the bar and it falls down? That's, they fell short. They didn't quite hit that mark. They didn't quite get where they were wanting to go. And in a similar kind of a way, if you can think about it with me, we don't ever get to that place of perfection, of doing things right all the time, that God does. But do you think God expects us to get things right all the time? Do you think God expects us to get things right all the time? No, he doesn't. In fact, he knows we're going to make mistakes and mess up. So when the Bible talks about sin, it's talking about something that, well, we're not getting it. We're not reaching that point of perfection that, of course, we would like to have. And because, and the thing is, the Bible says that sin is sin. So it could be something really mean and really just really bad that we do. But it can even be something as simple as having a mean thought in our head. Like, oh, I don't like that person because of what they did to me. And when you have your team time later with your team leaders, I like to encourage you to be talking with the kids on your team and ask them this question. What do you think sin is? And have a discussion about that. And maybe ask them, what is forgiveness and why is it important? And start a conversation. We're going to talk more about it this afternoon. When is it appropriate to have to extend forgiveness, and what does it mean to receive it? Here's some things for you to think about, talk about with the kids on your team. And then one other thing I'd like to say to you, boys and girls, before I invite Michael down to the stage, is you're getting warmed up. I'm glad to hear it. One more thing I want to encourage you in is I want to encourage you in how you use your words. The Bible says that God created everything out of by his word. He spoke all of creation into existence out of that which was invisible. Can you imagine? It's hard to imagine just nothing, right? But he created everything that you see and the world that we live in. He created us, the stars and the planets, the galaxies, the universe, out of that which was invisible. And it says in the Bible he spoke it into existence with his words. Do you think words are powerful? They're very powerful. I was thinking about this morning and was being reminded of the importance of using my words in very purposeful and in very kind ways. I want you to think about the words that you're speaking to each other this week. And I want you to ask yourself, don't answer me right now, I want you to ask yourself, am I being as kind in my words as I could be? Because God has given us the awesome ability to speak words out of our mouths. And I'll tell you what, your words and my words, they have the ability to build people up and encourage them or to tear them down and make them feel really bad. So think about it with your team, the other kids on your team, how you're speaking with them, how you're speaking with your team leaders, your SWATs, how you're speaking with your brothers or sisters. Hello. That's a hard one sometimes, right? And you might think, well, what about the way they speak to me? Well, I'll tell you what, speaking back to them in the way that you're speaking to the way that they're speaking to you, if they're not saying nice things, is not going to help the situation any. So think about your words and how are you using them? Are you able to say, God, thank you for the gift of being able to speak words, and I am just doing a great job all the time. I'm always speaking kind words. Let's be honest with ourselves, okay? And that could be also something that you could talk about with your teams. Now, none of this is meant to make you feel bad. It's just meant to, for all of us together, you kids and those of us who are adults, to think about how we're using our words. Okay? You've been super fantastic once again. Not surprised at all. You guys are an amazing group of kids. And right now, before we finish out our assemblies, I do want to invite Michael, so you can begin the chant. Michael Martinez, to come down to stage. And the point.
Okay, point princesses, come on down. We're gonna make this a big day. Everybody, you guys were fantastic earlier today. Great job. taking the pictures. You guys want to hear who won prizes this morning?
Oh, yeah.
That good? Okay, let's go right into it.
Okay, for the girls' team, it's Annie's team, the Sunflowers.
Sunflowers! Yeah, Sunflowers!
Good job, girls.
And then
well done.
We have Elisa's team, Primrose.
Go, Primrose. Okay, for the guys, third grade team, Team Dogwood. Nice and loud, people.
Dogwood.
Let me do it again. Team Dogwood.
Team Dogwood.
Yeah. Then sixth grade boys. You guys ready for this? Nice and loud this time, folks. Team Madrone.
Madrone, what up, Madrone?
Madrone.
Okay, thanks, you guys. Can you guys give a nice big cheer for the Points Princesses over here?
Points Princesses!
Yeah! You guys are doing such a great job. Thank you so much for helping us out today. Okay, so team leaders, we're going to have a very, 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 very quick team time before you guys go to the next thing after that, okay? So I believe we're going to already have the snacks out for you guys. So you get in there, have your snack, and then James will release you from there to go right into either projects or games. Got it? Great. So I'm going to release you now. Let's start with the younger kids going first. Go ahead.
First, second, third grade?
First, second, and third grade. Ready, go.